Hi, welcome back to my channel. I hope you are having a great day. Today we are going to be making this beautiful moon and the basketball hoop. So let's jump right into the painting. For this, the materials I will be using are a sheet of paper. I use an acrylic pad and I use one of those sheets. And then the acrylic paints, blue, brown, white, yellow, some purple, and some red. So those are the paints I'm using. I hope you'll enjoy this tutorial. First, I'm painting the base layer with dark blue and little bit of black mixed in that, to create a dark night sky look. So I'm laying down these colors in the first coat. Just so you know, I have lots of other paintings in my channel, in this video channel. So if you hit subscribe button, you'll be notified when I post any new paintings. I try my best to post at least 3 or 4 videos every week. And I make videos during night or late evenings. So that's how I relax my mind, by doing a daily painting. You don't have to put even colors. Just randomly use blue and black and just layer it on this sheet of paper. I'm using Deco Art acrylic paint, but any brand is fine. Towards the right side of the sheet, I'm laying down lighter colors compared to left hand side, because left side is a little darker sky and right side is where we are making the moon. So the reflection of the moon will create lighter sky towards the right side. Here I'm blending all those colors with the same brush. I'm using a soft brush for this. Towards the left side, I use a little more of the black and blue mix, and then I'm drying it with a hair dryer so that the base coating is dry before I draw the moon. And here I'm painting the lighter sky with little white and blue and teeny amount of black mixed, to create a lighter reflection on the sky. I think I should have used a larger brush to paint the sky, but I didn't use it. That's okay. Next time, I'm learning every single day. So next time I should use the larger brush to make the sky colors. I In any painting, I use lighter and darker shades to create interesting effect. Otherwise, using one color won't create the beautiful effect that we see in the painting. Always there should be lights and darks going on. I also mix little teeny amount of purple in the sky color, because plain black wouldn't look interesting. Keep on blending until you get the look that you like. And I didn't dip the brush in water for the first layer. I just used a dry brush with the deco art paint. But some acrylic paints they may use need some water. Then I'm laying out the moon with the Starbucks lid, Starbucks bottle, and with the lid I may make a round shape. For the moon, we will be using a tiny amount of yellow mixed with little white and tiny amount of some blue and some black to create a light grayish yellow for the moon. And then first I'm painting the edges of the moon, then we'll come back and make the center. Sometimes I also use modeling paste to create a texture for my paintings, but in this painting I'm not using any textures, but it's up to you. If you like some 3D, three-dimensional effect, I would use some texture paint in the moon. That will give even more dramatic effect. The base layer of the moon is almost done. I think it looks okay now. Then for the in-between portion, I mixed a little brown, dark brown, and then some yellow, and then I'm adding these shades in between. Just so you know, I got this reference picture from a site called Pixabay. There they have all copyright free pictures that you could use, and you should read the terms and condition of each image before you use it for your paintings. I normally use that site for any reference images. For the brighter shades of the moon, I'm using some white and some yellow mixed to create the highlights of the moon. Because normally the edges are a little brighter compared to the center. think this painting is very relaxing to make because it's so calming landscape. Some more brighter yellow towards the highlights of the moon. Now we are making the support for the basketball hoop. I used a palette knife because that palette knife gives an interesting effect, rather than using simple plain brush. I like the textures of the palette knife. If you do not have palette knife, I would use a credit card. I cut into little strips and I also use that sometimes on my paintings. Credit card gives the same effect. Just me mixing some blues and some browns and teeny bit of yellow is what I'm using. Adding some browns and blues in the basketball hoop support. For the highlights, I use some yellow mixed with some whites and again blues to create the shades where the moonlight hits. Palette knife gives an interesting effect. Sometimes I use a credit card. If I cut into strips, I use that for creating textures. And for the lines in between, I used some white paint I dipped in palette knife and applying this teeny white lines. I think so far it looks beautiful. This landscape is so calming. I feel so relaxing to make this painting. I usually make all these paintings during late evenings or midnight. I make these videos just so I can share with my friends. I make sure that I spend at least 15 to 30 minutes every day making a new painting. So that's why I started this YouTube channel, so as I'm painting I can share with my friends. For the basketball hoop, I mixed a little yellow and some white and I'm drawing with a thin brush. Like I said, in any area there should be lights and darks. Where the light hits, I use the lighter color, and underneath the basketball hoop, I use darker colors because light doesn't hit that portion. So see, I'm using dark black under the red portion. And where the moonlight hits, I use lighter red color. This is the rod that supports the basketball hoop. I use little white and blue mix. I love the color of the sky. It looks pretty. Again, we used for the sky a little purple, dark blue, ultramarine blue, and some black to create this beautiful sky. I hope you are enjoying my tutorial so far, and I hope you enjoy making the same painting at your end as well. Just so you know, I also have an Etsy site where I sell my original paintings. I make custom paintings for my customers in any size or in any color that they like. Some people, they send me the picture of their living room or dining room, and they request to make a painting, which I do. You could check it out on the description box, the website where I sell on Etsy. So far, I've sold many paintings, and I have every painting got good reviews on my Etsy channel. You could check it out. I started painting as a hobby, but then when some of my neighbors requested, I started this Etsy site, and now I'm shipping to every state in US. I make huge paintings, and I make it on canvas. And here for the demo, I use the acrylic pad, but normally I use a canvas to make acrylic paintings. And I also have another YouTube channel for simple paintings, like that kids can follow along. And in that site, I make doodles and other simple paintings that you could check it out as well. I put the link on the description box. In this site, I make some complex and medium to complex paintings, but in the other site, I make drawings, mainly simple ones, that kids can follow along or beginners can follow along. And this is the fun part. For the stars, I used a toothbrush, and I put little white paint mixed with some water in the toothbrush, and we are going to sprinkle on the night sky, so it will look like stars and will create tiny splatters that look like stars. See, like this. This is really fun. See how it looks so tiny, and it comes so natural. Doesn't look like we painted. It comes so natural, the stars. Looks really pretty. And I wanted to thank you for watching my video, and please hit the red subscribe button and the notification icon, which is the bell icon, so you will get notified as soon as I post any new painting. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope you enjoy making this painting at your end. Please feel free to comment on my video if you like me to make any new painting. Bye bye.